Hello everybody, Lurgs here, welcome to my channel, and today
it's how to transfer your iCloud photos and videos to your computer easily. If you use the iCloud on your iPhone to keep all your photos and videos for storage, then to transfer them onto your PC or laptop is a nice easy procedure. Now the reason you may want to do this is because, believe it or not, a lot of your photos and videos won't be stored on your iPhone anymore. If you use the iCloud for storage, although you can see them on your iPhone, these are smaller versions of the real versions, and you can prove this by looking at a video clip. So this particular video clip, if I click on edit at the top, you'll notice in the middle it says downloading. So this isn't actually on my iPhone, it's actually on the iCloud and it's downloading it from there. There's a couple of different settings on your iPhone. So if we go into settings, scroll down and then select photos. The iCloud photos is enabled and we've got it ticked on optimize phone storage. That basically means if your iPhone's low on space, full resolution photos and videos are replaced with smaller versions on your local iPhone. And full resolution versions of photos and videos can be downloaded from the iCloud, and that's what we'll do next. You can select download and keep originals, but this will fill up your iPhone very quickly. On your desktop PC or laptop, open up a web browser. I'm just going to go into Google Chrome, type in iCloud.com. It will then ask you to log in. Now this will be your Apple ID and your Apple ID password. So type that in, then type in your password. Depending on the security setup, a verification code may pop up on your iPhone and you need to put this into your web browser. Then press enter, then click on trust this browser, because I trust it because I'm on it myself. And then it logs you into your iCloud account. Now, oddly, it's saying good evening, Lurgs, and yet it's 9 o'clock in the morning. Very odd. Guess it's because Google is American. Now, when you log in, it defaults to moments. I prefer to have it on photos. That shows you all photos. And I've got 30 videos and 8 photos here on the iCloud. And if we quickly look at the iPhone, you can see that this matches identically. You can move this slider backwards and forwards to make the images larger. You can also select your albums in here like you've got on your iPhone. I'm just going to select photos. Now to download just a few selected photos or videos, hold down the control key on your keyboard and then use your mouse and then just left click and select all the photos and videos that you want to download. So I'm going to select this one, this one, and then a few more. So I've got 6 selected in total. Then what you do is up the top here, you've got this download option. Click on that, and then the bottom left hand corner, it's downloading that as a zip file. So that is all those 6 objects being downloaded. Now if we go to File Explorer in Windows, click on refresh, double click the .zip file, double click iCloud Photos. Then if we select extract to, I'm just going to extract it to downloads and click OK. That has now extracted those photos and that video clip down to the downloads folder. And these are all full resolution as they were filmed and shot. Fabulous. Now if you want to select all items from your iCloud, that is just as easy. So if we go back to the iCloud web browser, now, if you hold the shift key down on your keyboard and then use your mouse, so keep the shift key held down, select the first object in the iCloud and then scroll to the end and select the last object, all the time holding the shift key down. This selects all the objects. You can see there's 38 selected. Then click on the download option. It's now downloading all of those. I'm going to speed this footage up, 250 megabytes roughly. Click on refresh and there is that zip file with all those objects inside there. Nice and simple. Don't forget to log out of your iCloud for security. Just click on sign out, trust and sign out. You can also, if you want to, download iCloud for Windows and then it will automatically sync anything on the iCloud with your Windows app. And I tell you what, that definitely deserves a lovely cup of tea.
I hope you found that useful. Over here is a link on how to send voice memos from your iPhone to your computer. And up on this side, there's a link on what to do if your iPhone to laptop hotspot is not working properly. Thanks for visiting my channel, everyone. I really, really appreciate it.